Hello, hello, hello. Welcome on in, everybody. Welcome to tonight's live. Let me throw this in the chat real quick. I'm a couple minutes late. Sorry about that, everybody. I had sound difficulties. I had sound issues and it was me. I was the issue. So if you're new to the channel, hi, hello. My name is Tanya or TitaniumBuilt. This here behind me is Mia. She looks like she's having a rough day. There she is. She's perked up now. There we go. Get it together, Mia. Get it together. But welcome to the channel. If you're returning Titan, welcome on back for yet another upload. Appreciate it. Appreciate you guys coming in. I don't have anything set up like I usually do. So let me just get this stuff together. Because actually, we tacked on a couple more updates when I had the whole sound problem. So heads up, all of my loyal friend TitaniumBuilt as well. I understand that. I will limit my chat with certain people around true crime. I agree, Aries, for sure. Sorry, guys. This was from last night's live. If I don't like exit out of YouTube, it's weird. It'll just like play last night's live. Don't know what she's doing, but that's okay. So we're going to discuss a few different cases tonight. Let me get my crap together, maybe. Then we'll start. I don't have my tabs in any order. You know, I should. Check, check. Hello. Check, check. Mic check. I actually had the mic over here prior to the live coming on to you, like right before the live. I was like, what's my microphone doing over here? Vincent's not here tonight, so he's not helping me. See, I have like my books are in the way. Like, aesthetic, Tanya. Aesthetic. Look, you got your pink little notebook hanging out. I'm the craziest when it comes to that stuff, though. Like when you can hear like background noises or like the mouse clicking, I have like a silent mouse or like the keyboard. I don't know. That just gets my ears going. So who's all in here tonight? I saw A.R. Hayes was in here and I saw Ashley was in here earlier. I saw that and I popped in. Hey, Cheryl. Hey, Ladybug. Catherine's in here. DM. Everyone's here for the news. Hey, Ryan, what's up? It's been a while, but I think it was just the other night. Well, hey, Gwen, thank you for becoming a member. I appreciate that so very much. You don't even know. We love members. We love subscribers, though, too. I am going to do a members-only video. I was going to ask you guys if you wanted to do one tomorrow, actually. Maybe, like, in the afternoon. So there's Gwen, and we got Avamos. Where are we at there? Hey, Avamos. Hey, DM. I don't know if I said your name or not yet. Hey, Mike. Welcome in, everybody. It's good to see you guys. I figured, why not come on and do a live? Remember how I said I was going to take a break today? Yeah, I didn't. We had too much stuff come out in true crime, so I had to come on. Voodoo, hello. If I say that I'll take a day off after like something comes out, like if I say I'll take a day off, you know, when there's no true crime, then I'll be sitting here for, you know, the rest of my life. Trisha. Oh, Ashley got some good news. For Booth, hang. Oh, we got her first call, and we go to the Kidney Transplant Center in Lancaster. Oh, that's awesome. For March 12th to get tested and get processed going. That is the best news. That's not good news. That's the best news. That's really good news. So if she gets the kidney transplant, no more dialysis and stuff. I feel so bad for her. For both of you. I mean, you're just as much, you know, you're hooking it up and you're helping. And hey, Yankee Kyle, I couldn't imagine having to. Well, I can't imagine having a sick loved one. I've been there, but you know, a sick significant other. I couldn't imagine that. I couldn't imagine. Hey, Otto. Look at that. Aries and Otto in chat again. Oh, my Lord. It's Christmas. Christmas all around. Hey, Sirius Black. Hey, is it Ella Blue? I think it's Ella Blue. I like that name. My dog's name was Ella. I love that name, actually. That's why I picked it. I love the name Ella. And Jesus loves me. I'm sorry if I miss anybody. I'm sorry. My eyes aren't the greatest. We all know that. Hey, Richie. Hey, Amanda. Hey, everybody. Hey, Roseanne. Welcome in, everybody. So if you guys don't mind just taking a second, you know, hit the like button, all the fun things that we tell you to do. If you're not subscribed to the channel and you do appreciate tonight's case coverage, I hope you'll consider subscribing to the channel. We do talk true crime here daily. Normally, I'm not this much of a mess. Okay, I lied. I'm always this much of a mess. Don't let me fool you. Look at that. 11 months, Dreamcatcher. Oh my gosh, you're so close. You're so close. Hey, true crime and other stuff. We have to get that one. So I'm going to actually ask you guys too. Maybe I'll do that on a post, but we need to think of a one-year member badge. We're trying to think of something really cool. We should have saved the rainbow, I think, till the 1 year, because like it's rainbow. What can you top with rainbow? So I thought, what if we did like two titanium arms for 1 year? Like you'll get two of them, and then you'll go back to being silver, but you'll have the two. I don't know. We're going to try to figure something out. If you guys have anything, drop it in the comments. Let me know. Could make a star. So we have like right now we have the arms for like, cause I'm made of metal. So that's like my name. So we did like a titanium arm, and then each like for 3 months, you get a color every 6 months or 1 month, 3 months, 6 years, 6 months and 1 year. So now I got to figure out how I'm going to top the 6 month or a cup of tea. I could. The cup of tea sounds good. Like for my second channel. Yeah, and don't worry, we got your back. Oh, Aries, you'll see things behind the scenes if you're in this community. Thanks, Tawny. I thought it was a cute idea, and then now I'm going to have to think of a better one. So I think maybe we'll do the two. If we can make it to where it shows up beside your name, because if it's going to be too small, then we'll make it better. Yeah, so if you're a member for 6 months, that's what you'll get. You'll get your titanium, or you get your rainbow arm, and then for 1 year, we're still trying to figure that part out. So I have a ton, tons and tons, tons to show you guys. You say you're made of metal. I say you are made of compassion and beauty. Oh, thank you, AR. I appreciate that. I really do. But I'm made of that metal too. And oh, I actually didn't get to show you guys. I was going to show you my arm. It's not as bad as it looks, but it really bruised up today. Do you see that? That's from me falling the other day. I'm like, good golly. I had on short sleeves before the live. And I was like, people are going to think that Vincent Dunn threw me down the stairs or something. But no, I put a sweatshirt on and I was like, I'll just show them because you guys were worried. I saw one of you guys, I think it was Otto, said, go get x-rays. I'm okay. It's nothing, feels broke or nothing. It's just very tender, very bruised. So I fell walking into the door. I don't know what I do. The YouTube streets are crazy. They really are. They really are. They get crazier and crazier. Like just when you think you got enough crazy, you're like, oh, this is just my first year into YouTube. And then you're like, it gets even crazier. Yeah, serious. Me too. We don't like that. We don't like fake stuff around here. So we're going to go over, let's see, which one should we go first? I'm going to let you guys know which cases we're going to cover tonight real quick, because I don't have any rhyme or reason for this live tonight. Like I have a bunch of stuff that's, pinned at the top of my, up at the top of my, whatever this is, screen. And we're just going to go with it. We just going to go with it. And welcome in. It's good to see everybody. Hey, preschool granny, welcome in. So let's see here. What do we have? So we're going to go over Harmony Montgomery, of course. We'll probably start off with that one. Start off with great news. Audrii Cunningham, of course. Elijah Vu, he is the little boy that we discussed on last night's live for a minute. I just kind of brought the case up to you guys. He's a little boy that's missing. And Madalena Kojikari. I have an update. I hope Wist is in the chat tonight. If Wist comes in, remind me to do the update again. Because me and Wist were actually just talking about Madalena in the chat last night. I don't know if you guys remember me talking about her. She's a little girl that went missing back in 2022. Not a whole lot of people. I don't think a whole lot of people know about her case. She's not from this country. Her and her mom moved here from Russia, or a spot near Russia. And so basically she's missing. Her mother's in jail. She's not producing the child. Lori Vallow vibes. And now they're going to be going, they're going forward with the, with her court dates. So I'm excited because we haven't heard anything about this case in forever. So I got to figure out what time the stream is tomorrow. It's going to be tomorrow morning. I think she's going to be in there. So we'll go through it together because I saw it and I just pulled it up and I was like, we'll watch this and we'll figure it out together. And then I saw someone said something about Nancy Grace posted about Audrii, I think it might have been the ones that we watched, but let me know. I forget who said that. She's been on it. Let's see, where should we start first? We'll start with Adam Montgomery. They reached a verdict today. I'm sure everybody knows that they reached a verdict in Harmony Montgomery's trial. Now, this little girl was missing for 2 years before anyone even knew that she was missing. Outside of her dad, her, and her stepmother. I finally felt like today, like she got a little bit of justice. Like it's Harmony's day. That sick coward couldn't even come into the courthouse to be at least read his charges like a man, or, you know, his sentencing like a man. Couldn't even do it. Oh, maybe it's something different. Was it on YouTube DM? I'll have to look. So they reached a verdict. Guilty, 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 guilty. Guilty. Let me tell you, I never do this. It's like my second time in 2 weeks I've done this. I took another nap today. And when I woke up, I was like, I'm going to go take a nap. Because I said that this was going to be 2 hours and 16 minutes. The jury would be back deliberating and they would be back. And it was like hour 9 or something, or 8. And I'm like, I'm going to take a nap. Or maybe it was a little bit before that. And then when I woke up, I was like, what's going on? I was on a chat. Now I'm not in the chat room anymore. So I saw that they did have a verdict for him. So coward to the end. Yeah. I mean, maybe he'll be able to tell he's not going to tell them nothing, but you know, maybe he's thinking of a way to like tell the people inside the jail that he didn't do this. I don't know. I didn't show up, so I didn't do it, bro. I mean, he's going to be living a very hard life. And I hope it's so hard. Every single day, I hope he wakes up and he sees that little girl smile. Let me see if I can find it really quick, because this was really, really sweet. Man, I hope I can find it. Harmony Montgomery's little brother said something about her today. And I pinned it and I forgot about it. But I forgot what it said. It said something along the lines of, here it is. Okay. Jameson said this before bed. So Jameson was her brother, and Jameson got adopted, and the guy that adopted Jameson wanted to adopt Harmony as well. They thought, okay, so they thought they were going to adopt one boy, but then they found out Jameson had a sister, and he's like, okay, so are we adopting two kids today? Are we adopting one? You let us know. Like, who says that? It's not a puppy. These guys are angels on earth. Angels on earth. So him and his husband, they adopted Jameson. And so last night when Jameson was going to sleep, he said this just before bed. He said, and you know, little kids, God, can you bring my family member back to life? It's my sister Harmony. Please, God, do this one thing, and please don't let anyone hurt her glasses. Man, I can't even hardly read that without crying. Sorry, guys. That's really sad. Wow. When you read it in your mind, it's not as bad when you read it out loud. When you read it out loud, it's really heartbreaking. Because kids don't lie. Kids are so innocent. Like, oh my God, can you imagine him? And the little boy's got everything. This little boy, he could be looking straight ahead, not looking back. You know, I got out. But he's not, he always wants to put her there whenever they do things. It's so heartbreaking. That's so heartbreaking. I hope this guy never has a peaceful day in his life. I hope he can't even take a shit in the morning in peace. Well, he can't because everyone's going to be watching him now, but you know. Says jurors found New Hampshire father Adam Montgomery guilty in the M of his 5-year-old daughter Harmony. After about 6 hours of deliberation over 2 days, I guess it was 6 hours. It seemed like forever because it was 2 days. Today, our thoughts are focused on the memory and legacy of Harmony Montgomery, a little girl who did not deserve the tragic fate that she suffered. Our hearts go out to Harmony's family and all of those who knew and loved her, and we hope today brings them some closure and peace. After he realized she was dead, according to investigators, he concealed the body for months, heartlessly crushing her into a duffel bag and then a cooler, and coating her with lime to reduce the odor of decomp. Look at him. That was the first day. Remember the first day? Swinging in, strutting his shit. That was the one day you went in there. Look at him. I like this picture of him because you know he ain't looking like that now. You know he ain't looking like that now. Eventually, he allegedly, no, he did, rented a U-Haul truck and dumped her battered remains like trash somewhere outside Boston. Now, I almost thought with this trial we were going to find out where she was. Right, Harley Ryder? Kayla should not rest well either. Nope. Mm-mm. This is like this. We've dealt with so many cases on the kids cases on the channel lately, and it's so much like parents, grandparents, friends, families. They're all just they're really not doing what they need to be doing for these children. It's just, I mean, you know, they're not. I mean, he moved her from he took her and he put her in a trash bag. Then he put her in a tote. Well, first she was in a suitcase, and then she was in the back trunk. Then she was in the trash bag and then the tote. Then she was put in the stroller between the two other little babies by Kayla, by her own words. Like, how does she not get more time? And it's so, I don't know. I just, when it's women, it's even worse, I feel like. I don't know. It's bad when either does it, but when it's a woman, you know, I don't know. It just gets me, it hits me harder. I don't know. I think it's because women are, we're made to be nurturing. We were meant to be. I don't know. Kayla, it must have missed Kayla completely because her excuse was, I just looked forward. I didn't see anything. Then he said nothing for nearly 2 years. Harmony was finally reported missing when her frustrated non-custodial mother, Crystal Sorey, discovered the child had never been enrolled in school. Manchester police declared her a missing person in December 2022. Montgomery, a 33-year-old violent felon and drug addict, had somehow been awarded custody of Harmony after his release from prison for shooting a drug dealer in the face, even as his brother's adoptive parents were actively trying to add her to their family. This is not a day we celebrate, her brother's adoptive parents, Blair and Jonathan Miller, said in a statement moments after jurors announced their verdict. It is the day that only adds to the incredible pain and heartache that surrounds a little girl who was never given a chance. That's the truth. Jameson Harmony's brother has been praying for her to return every night, they said. Jameson would go to the front door hoping Harmony would find us, they said. Because he realizes he moved, you know, and he's like, but she won't know where to find us. I can't imagine being his parents, like Jameson's dads, you know. They're angels. He would search for her in a park as we now dig deep within our hearts to find the ability to offer forgiveness. We look to our son to give him the strength to fight off the demons that this tragedy has brought for a lifetime. A Massachusetts watchdog agency later found that the state child welfare system did not prioritize her needs, well-being, and safety in placing her in her father's care. While collecting welfare on her behalf, Montgomery lived out of a car with his now estranged wife, Kayla, whom he is also accused of beating and continued to use drugs, prosecutor said. Her testimony at trial is key evidence in the case. Now, I don't know if I believe half the crap she said either. As part of a plea deal, Kayla gave investigators damning testimony implicating her husband on charges that include second-degree M, abusing a corpse, and falsifying evidence. She told detectives that Adam kept Harmony's body for 3 months, repeatedly hiding it in a new place before allegedly dumping it somewhere near Boston. Although the girl's body has not been recovered, investigators allegedly found her DNA in at least one location where he allegedly stowed it. And we know where that was, in the ceiling vent. On December 7, 2019, the day investigators believe Harmony died, she soiled herself in her sleep, prosecutors said. Her father allegedly beat her over the head viciously, telling his wife, I think I really hurt her this time. And then they went to the methadone clinic, picked up drugs and got fast food. Now, I know in my little mind, and in my little heart, he was fiending for the drugs. He's fiending for the methadone. He was fiending for one. He needed one or the other. And I do believe that Harmony was terrified of her father and that she wouldn't have even asked him that day to stop by a restroom. There was no stopping. They were going to the methadone clinic. Harmony knew better. Don't ask for McDonald's if you see the golden arches. Don't ask for Burger King if you see the little Burger King guy. You know what I mean? Like, don't ask for nothing. You just go wherever they're going until they're happy. Because then children can feel tensions, you know? So they know after daddy goes to this one place in the morning, he's usually a little happier. So I'll ask him after. Maybe that's what she was going to do. And then she had the accident. And then he freaked because he didn't have his stuff. He was out of control. He was unhinged. And I believe that Kayla was the same way. That's why she turned and she just kept facing forward because she wanted her methadone as well. Don't get her twisted. And then they decided, well, I feel better now. You know, oh, I feel better now. She'll be okay, right? Yeah, she'll be fine now. Because I feel better. She'll feel better. And then they go to Burger King. Now, I swear, I want to see that Burger King receipt. I want to see that they paid for a Happy Meal or something for Harmony. Because then we'll know if she was dead or alive then. Kayla's not going to be charged Elizabeth Lander. Nope, she gets off. She gets off, I think, 3 years. She gets. And then Kayla tried to say she was giving her food like this, but not looking back. And her kids as well. Just, I have never seen an adult pass a child something like this, that's like a French fry or a hamburger a day in my life. Normally they turn around and they set it, you know, don't spill nothing in the car, kids, you know, but like sit on their lap or something. Or they give them the whole box. You know, they turn around, they give them the whole Happy Meal box. They don't just pass stuff over their shoulder. He knew that baby was gone, Ashley. Yep, you're absolutely right. I believe so. So I won't read through the rest of it, but you know, he just beat her and beat her and beat her. And it says she died moaning and gurgling. As prosecutors said, he ate his food and shot up some drugs. He was already serving a minimum of 32 and a half years. So if I was Adam's age, like how was he? He's younger than me, 33, I think. If somebody told me that I was going to be in jail for the next 32 years, guaranteed, I don't know. I'd be like, I'm in here for life. That's what she said. They were talking about getting money for drugs. And she said she would give Harmony a croissant sandwich and split hers with the boys. Yeah. Yeah. Here you go. No, Kayla's not going to. She's going to be free bird. She's going to be a free bird here soon. I think it's May of this year or something like that. It's coming up. It's not that long. Not that far. That man, that James, that's heartbreaking. This is going to be another heartbreaking case, but we've got some confirmation. I did not think that this was going to be out this quick with Audrii. I'm sorry, I was trying to pause this at the same time as talking. Audrii's case, I didn't realize that they were going to have a cause of death like listed. Oh, Wist, I'm glad you're here. We have a Madalena Kojikari update. Her mom is going to court tomorrow. Yeah, I'm really excited about that. And I wanted to tell you because I knew you were like, we were just talking about that last night. So, because I was a little salty the other day when I felt like all of these people are out like looking for Audra. And, you know, they had the $7,000 reward, then they increased it to a $10,000 reward. I was like, why can't we do this for all kids? Because Madalena has nobody here. Like, she has no family in this, the whole country. And nobody's looking for her other than the cops. And it's very sad. They're a small, like, police agency. So that's why, and then we started talking about it in the chat. And I was like, we need to get them funded. These are the things that need to be funded. You know, when a child goes missing, every resource that, you know, that we have should be able to be used immediately. For that missing child, not no 24 hours, 40 hours later, you go out there and you start looking immediately. I think foundations may help, but I don't know. I'm gonna have to look into that because they need to have a big reward or something for Madalena. I don't even know who would tell because I feel like it was just her and her mom. I saw that solo. I saw a little bit of it. Like, I didn't get to watch half of it, but I did get to watch a little bit of it. So it says, autopsy confirms how Audrii Cunningham died before she was dumped into the Trinity River. Second one this in the last 2 years, Athena Strand, and then this little girl to be by the Trinity or in the Trinity. As Audrii's Cunningham's family gets ready to honor her memory next weekend, we now know what caused her death. An autopsy showed the 11-year-old Livingston girl died from homicidal violence, including blunt head trauma, according to the Harris County Medical Examiner's Office. Audrii's body was recovered from the Trinity River under U.S. 59 Tuesday following an extensive six-day search. Wow. It was 6 days? Wow. I didn't realize it was 6 days. I don't know why. Like, it felt like longer, but it felt like not that long at the same time. Wow. Don Stephen McDougal, 42, is charged with capital M in Audrii's death, and he remains in the Polk County Jail without bond. McDougal lives in a camper behind the family's home, and he was on law enforcement's radar from the beginning. Polk County Sheriff Byron Lyons said McDougal was supposed to take Audrii to the bus stop on Thursday, February 15th, but she never arrived, and she wasn't at school that day. I mean, law enforcement, I know you had your eye on them from the beginning, but I mean, I think we all had our eye on them from the beginning, you know. So they're saying, no. So Brad, people are saying that, but no, she's too little. She didn't even have I'm sure she didn't even have her period yet. Like, looking at her at 11 and looking at me at 11, we'd be looking two different ways. I don't know why. I looked like I was more, I looked more. I look like I do now, I feel like. I've always looked this way, but not as many wrinkles. But yeah, she was a baby. I don't think she would have been able to have a baby yet. Right? You have to have your period and things like that. I don't think she would. But I know that, her birthday was February 5th. Yeah, she had just turned 11. So I'm trying to think of when I was like 12 or 13, 12. But I know that some girls get their period younger. Can you imagine? Nah, I don't think. I think that. So I think what it is now, it's these people like they're wanting more to the story. You know, when there's a new case out there, everybody gets like there's like a feeling that you get when you're trying to investigate a case or you're trying to learn all the details. Well, now that we're getting all those details and it's starting to go from this up high to this down low, people are going to be throwing out everything. You know, I'm surprised that didn't come out sooner just because it was a girl and a boy, a girl and a little boy. I'm going to call him that because he ain't no man. But let me see. Youngest. Okay, we're going way back. My Lord. Don't ever look that up. Just don't look that up. Don't look up stuff. I put youngest girl to get pregnant. I shouldn't have put that part. That was 5 years old. But this was back in 1933. So that's probably not like... When does the average, here we go. Maybe we'll just look this up. Average girls, 12 years old, can start as early as 8, but most girls start when they're about 12. So I would say, I don't know. We'll find out, though, when the full report comes out. I do have the website to go on to and everything. It is very funky to get on. Plunder was right about that. So I'll have to navigate it, like try to like navigate it better. It's not the user's fault. Like, it's not mine. It's like the actual website. It's very glitchy. So, and welcome in, everybody. Welcome in. Hey, PKC. Keep up the chatter. Mm-hmm. Oh, and I got to show a comment. Sorry. Oh, that's Ashley's. I should have known. I'm like, oh, I got to show a comment because it's just me. So we do have confirmation. It was homicidal violence. Now, I kind of want to know what that means. Like, if it's... definition of it. Is when a person causes serious physical harm to another person, resulting in the victim's murder. It can also be defined as death from anything other than natural causes. So I guess it's just something that they, a word that they use, homicidal violence. I'm assuming that it's, I mean, I would assume any kind of homicide would be violent. I mean, now that I'm thinking about it, I'm like, wait a minute. That doesn't even sound right. So let me exit out some of this stuff so I don't, so I know where I'm at. So we all know where we're at. I want to see if there's anything new on each case as we're going to go through too. Oh, that's what it is. Nancy spoke with Tim Miller, the searcher who found the location of Audrii Cunningham's body. He reveals the article of clothing belonging to her that was found on the river's edge. Let's see. Because what I try to do is I tried to listen to this earlier. And this is weird. So it's like an hour episode. But I wonder if it's the episodes we already listened to. You know what I mean? Because that sounds right. An hour. This one says 1 hour and 6 minutes. We listened to way more than an hour worth of, I don't know. I'll have to listen to it. And if it's all new information, like not all new information, but you know, if it's new, the one that we didn't listen to before, we can play it definitely tomorrow or something. But I know that she did talk to somebody on her podcast. So I'm wondering, because normally she goes on Apple Podcasts and that's where I was on. I didn't go on Spotify. Like when I saw that earlier, I didn't even click Spotify. So I'm like, oh, I went to Apple, and then I went to Apple Podcast and it wasn't on there. And I was like, oh, that's weird. Yeah, it might have been updated maybe, but it was weird because Nancy, like, she usually, sometimes she'll be a day behind, and she actually like went back into the studio or clipped on the end of her live or her video, like that they had found Audrii's body. And I was like, wow, they actually said that at the end because I thought we were going to miss that part. Well, no, she's wearing a different shirt. Because she's wearing her freedom shirt.
Now to some breaking news. Just 30 minutes ago, KHOU.
Heavens, everything's going. Sorry, guys. Sorry. I'm like, man, all the tabs are going. Okay. So we'll play this and we'll listen. It's like a 48 second clip. And then, yeah, we can play this week. Because, you know, I have no problem listening to Nancy. And I love Nancy when it comes to kids. Because Nancy don't mess around. She said heads are going to roll last night. And she meant it. She was pissed.
Yeah. Got me so upset thinking about her being separated from her clothes. Now, I don't know what piece of clothing it is. It could have been a shirt. It could have been her pants. It could have been her underwear. But when you said it's definitely evidence, that makes me think it could have been her underwear.
Well, it was definitely clothing, and it's definitely hers. So I decided to start doing side.
Was it her pants?
Answer. Oh.
Why does an 11-year-old girl not have her pants on?
Why'd he rape her? Why did he answer Nancy? He should know better than to answer Nancy. She straight said, she straight asked him.
He raped her. He raped her. This animal raped this 11-year-old girl.
Yeah.
Got me so upset thinking about her being separated from her clothes. Now, I don't know what piece of clothing it is. It could have been a shirt. It could have been her pants. It could have been her underwear. But when you said it's definitely evidence, that makes me think it could have been her underwear.
Well, it was definitely clothing, and it's definitely hers. So I decided to start doing side.
Was it her pants?
Yeah.
Why does an 11-year-old girl not have her pants on? He raped her.
Especially if she was going to school.
He raped her. This animal raped this 11-year-old girl.
Well, I mean, I'm not saying he didn't. I'm saying technically the pants could have came off in the water, but if he found the pants, then yeah. Yeah. I thought here someone said it was pajama pants. I'm wondering what she had on that day for school. I forget what they said she was wearing. Now I'm going to look at the missing fire. Let me see. If I can find that now. I mean, you know how things happen. Nope, here it is. Okay. Yeah, they didn't even have her anything. Wait, no, they did. Okay. Last seen wearing a black hoodie with a red Hello Kitty bag. Now, who gave the description, I wonder? Like, who was this person to last see her, I wonder? People tell Nancy things they shouldn't. Yeah, Elizabeth, probably too. She's like, was it her pants? And he's like, yep. Yes, ma'am. You know what I mean? Like, well, it's Nancy. What do you expect supposed to say? That's why she's a prosecutor for so long. She did a great job. Oh, you guys. I haven't had an eye twitch in like 2 weeks. And then all of a sudden it just started again. The glasses are going back on. Okay. So we'll move on to our next case that we'll cover this evening. Or we have two more. Let me make sure. And so what I'll do tonight is after the live or tomorrow, I'll look that up, that Nancy Grace podcast, and I'll listen through it. That way I could put pictures behind it for you guys. That way you guys have something visual to look at. And if it's new, then I'll definitely play it. Because y'all know me, I love to hear Nancy's take on things. I've been listening to her since I was a little tot myself. So I just want to see what I have. I have like pages, I have tabs everywhere. So I don't want to miss anything that I wanted to show you guys either. Okay. Okie dokie. So we'll go ahead and we'll do the case. We'll do Madalena Kojikari update. But here it says, let me see here. Okay. Let me go over to the tab that I need to be on. Let's see here, right here. Okay. So I saw this today when I was actually getting ready to start the live. Like I was in a little bit of a hurry and I was like, well, we're going to watch this together because I don't know exactly what time tomorrow in court. So I'm going to find out and then I will be live. If she walks into that courtroom, we will be live to watch her walk into that courtroom. But let me see where we are. Okay. So happening tomorrow, it says, I'm just going to play the video here. And we'll listen to it together. If you guys don't mind just taking a second to hit the like button, it really does help the channel. It helps the algorithm. It helps me. And if you don't mind and you like the content, don't forget to subscribe to the channel. We do Talk True Crime Daily.
An important development taking place tomorrow in the case of Madalena Kojikari, the missing girl from Cornelius, last seen in 2022.
It's a case WBTV has been following for more than a year. Tomorrow, her mother is scheduled to be arraigned in a Mecklenburg County court on charges connected to her disappearance.
So, Jamie, this is Madalena getting off her school bus on November 21st in 2022. It was the last time, there she is, she was seen publicly. But investigators say her mother didn't report her missing until nearly a month later. Cornelius police began an investigation the next day.
Diana Kojikari, Madalena's mother, and Christopher Palmiter, her stepfather, were later arrested for failing to report her missing. You may remember, though, Palmiter bonded out of jail last August.
Our Caroline Hicks sat down with the former prosecutor and former Mecklenburg County Assistant District Attorney to get a preview of tomorrow.
The story is all new, live at 5.
These parents were charged back in 2022. So now here we are in 2024. Is it?
Let me give you guys a little rundown on Madalena's case. Because I know a lot of people don't know about Madalena. And Madalena needs to be heard. Because this case means a lot to me. Like, you know how there's a case you come in on? And this one's it. I didn't come in on this case. I came in before this case. But after Kylie Rodney, and then it was during Quentin Simon's case, was when Madalena went missing. So everybody was so laser focused on these other cases that were going on. I feel like Madalena she didn't have a whole lot of, a lot of people on YouTube didn't cover her story, I feel like. She does. Yep. She has the mother from Russia, the grandmother that came over and said, I just want to take my daughter and granddaughter home. No, lady, you can't do that. Your daughter did something to your granddaughter. So basically, short version, Madalena went to school on the 21st. She got off the school bus at almost 5 o'clock that evening. She was tardy out of school for 2 weeks after that. Her school on December 15th, about December 15th, they came to her home to do a leave a truancy packet because that's what schools do now. Her mom said, this is what her mom said, I'll have her in there December 15th and I'll bring her to the school. She didn't bring her to the school. She showed up with no child. So they ended up arresting Madalena's mother and her stepfather, Chris Paltmeller, on charges of failure to report a child missing. They did a couple searches in their home. We went over the search warrants, did things like that. The mother's been in jail ever since. She's not talking. She's not talking. But then her mom flies over from, you know, another country. I think it's around Russia, but I don't think it's in Russia, but I think it's around there. And she's pretty much just says, like, let my daughter go. Let me go. We'll just leave. We'll just leave your country. Like, you can't just leave the country because you did something wrong. Like, your mama can't come over and come get you. I'm sorry. So that's why I'm like, there needs to be like more for her. I feel like we'll have to do another live. I did one not too long ago over this case, but it's been a little while. It's been probably 6 months, maybe not that long. It hasn't been that long, probably 4 months. So her stepfather, true crime and other stuff, he left that night. So the day that Madalena was reported missing, the night before, her stepdad supposedly left the house. He wasn't there. He decided to drive to Michigan Thanksgiving Day. He decided to drive to Michigan. What? You know, and then he comes home. So Diana Kojikari is aware that her daughter is missing because she's not in the house. But she doesn't call her husband and say, hey, is Madalena with you? She waits 2 full days for him to return home. And then she asks him, hey, is Madalena with you? And he says, no. Is Madalena with you? Why are you asking each other that? Like, that's the dumbest thing I've ever heard. You should automatically be calling. If you don't know where your kid is, you wake up the next morning, you go check on your kid, the kid's gone, the husband's gone. I would assume he took her with him, but I would call and say, hey, Madalena with you, what's going on? Yes, never seen the stepdad was with her. Yep, stepdad took her everywhere. Yep, Elizabeth, yeah. And the thing is too, there was a YouTube creator on this platform and they left the platform, they covered the Madalena case to the point where they have her cat. Like her cat, right? Well, then Madalena had a 1 year anniversary, 2 year anniversary ago. And this creator came back to the platform to talk about Ruby Frank, but didn't even talk about her. I was like, y'all, I was upset because Madalena is the case that gets me in my feels. Exactly, Ladybug. There's so much about this case, guys. If I told you all of it, you'd be like, what? Like, it's literally Lori Ballow. The only difference is, she didn't run to Hawaii. Madalena's mom hasn't run away to Hawaii to get married yet. Like, but they've both failure to report a child missing. And Tawny Lee, I'm trying. I really am trying to keep her name out there because I feel like there's not a lot of people are talking about her. The only thing I can really find are like the smaller clips of these little channels, Now News Nation did two videos on her, but that's been months ago. So maybe we'll see some justice tomorrow.
Startup. In the state court system, it is not unusual that it's taken this long for at least one of them to have their arraignment. There's no true speedy trial in North Carolina. So in the Mecklenburg County,
we've been waiting for years.
It is not unusual that arraignment is just now happening for Madalena's mom.
What can we expect from that arraignment?
So at her arraignment, she will either plead guilty or not guilty. Judge Curitan, who I believe is assigned to preside over the courtroom on Friday, will review her charges with her. She will have her counsel present. I believe she's represented by Susan Wiegand Williams from the Public Defender's Office. And at that time, she will be asked whether or not she pleads guilty or not guilty.
Based on that, how do we move forward? from that point.
So if she pleads guilty on Friday, then she will actually also be sentenced on Friday.
She has already been in jail for more than a year. How does that affect her sentencing?
While she's charged with a felony, she is only charged with a low-level felony, which is the failure to report that a child is missing.
How is that low-level?
Which I don't believe she does. It is conceivable that she has already served more time than she could actually receive as punishment under the North Carolina sentencing guidelines.
Shut the front freaking door. What? So she's saying mom could be let out tomorrow even if she pleads guilty? Failure to report a child, you should be in jail for the rest of your life until you produce the child. No ifs, ands, or buts. No ifs, ands, or buts. You don't produce the child, you don't get out of jail. I am so mad right now. I should have watched this before I came on. I normally watch my videos before I come on so I don't get upset, because when it comes to kids, I get upset. Did she really say that? I'm gonna rewind this back. Oh, my Lord. This is in North Carolina. This is in Mecklenburg. It's Mecklenburg PD, and it's in Cornelius, North Carolina. And I'm about to take a trip down there.
Jail.
Now, if Bullhorn Betty, now if she wants to grab the bullhorn and meet me down there, I'm all for that one. You know, Quentin Simon, we didn't need any of that mess. But this one, we need an uproar. We need people to be like, this is insanity. If she says that, I'm going to fall out of this chair. Like, how fast can I get to North Carolina?
For more than a year. How does that affect her sentencing?
While she's charged with a felony, she is only charged with a low-level felony, which is the failure to report that a child is missing. If she does not have a criminal record, which I don't believe she does, it is conceivable that she has already served more time than she could actually receive as punishment under the North Carolina sentencing guidelines.
But it's her kid. It's not like she failed to report this little tyke over here missing. I mean, anything, it should be way more than that. But what happened to common decency? Man. I know, Rhonda. I look all the time. I type Madalena's name in my search bar probably like, I mean, at least four times a week, I feel like. At least a couple times a week. I'm always searching. So when I saw this today, it was very surprising, especially because I made such of a ruckus last night about it. Oh, Elizabeth, you live there? Well, get my bail money too then. Make sure I got... Brittany lives close. Brent, we'll pick her up on the way. Someone get me some bail money ready though, because I got a mouth and I got me some hands to go with it. Just kidding. No, Mystic. No, not at all. Just made me think of that bullhorn in front of when she went to, remember when they went from Quentin Simon's house down to the jail and they weren't even open? Like they went down to protest and they weren't even, no one was there because they weren't, it was a holiday. Oh man. I'm sorry. That made me laugh. I guess they're good for a laugh. You know, I guess I needed that little bit of a laugh because man, this, if she walks out of there tomorrow, I mean, we're going to need to stream this because I will break everything around me. I'm just kidding. I won't, but I might. I might be that man, but I wouldn't do that.
It is possible,
but I might.
Her attorney has negotiated some type of time served sentence, or that she's even going in and pleading without the benefit of a plea agreement with the state and just doing what is called a straight up guilty plea because she knows that she's already done more time than she could receive under the sentencing guidelines.
So it's possible that she could walk, even though to this date, we don't know where Madalena is.
That is correct.
Her husband received a lower bond, although they are facing the same charge, and he bonded out of jail. Can you kind of explain whether that's unusual, that two people facing the same charge are facing such different circumstances?
Well, they both said he was gone. They both said he was in Michigan that night.
It's not unusual. There could be any number of circumstances.
If that's what it is.
People plead not guilty and this moves forward to a trial, how long could that potentially take?
The district attorney's office is working to, you know, still work through the backlog of jury trials that defendants have requested that's existing because of COVID. It could take a while. So there's not a whole lot the defense, unfortunately, can do to sort of push the pace.
Our Caroline Hicks reporting. Again, Diana Kojikari will be in court tomorrow. WBTV will be there. So be sure to check back tomorrow. And as always, make sure you have the WBTV News app downloaded. We will send out a push alert just as soon as we learn what happens.
He fills that big void that I had from not having...
I don't know what we're watching, but... My left. Shoot. I want to go back, but it won't let me. There we go. Okay. I don't know what news station this was, but they'll say it again. So I just wanted to keep that pin so I would know. That way, because they didn't tell us what time tomorrow, did they? Did they say a time? Hey, Ron, I don't think we have a time. And welcome back in, everybody. Or welcome in, everybody. I was going to say hi to back on my BS, but I know there was a bunch of people that came in too. So welcome in, everybody. Sorry when I'm reading. It's hard to see the two screens. And would you stop walking around? People probably don't like that, Mia. I didn't notice it, so I don't even know how long she was doing that. Sorry, guys. Look, she got back in her spot. Get in your spot, Mia. Call Born Her Betty. Yeah. I'm at a loss for words, you know? I really am. Because if she knows this, right, and I'm sure her public defender told her, hey, girl, if you plead out tomorrow, if you plead guilty tomorrow, you can leave tomorrow. But if you plead, I'm not guilty, they're going to keep you in there. But if you plead, this is crazy. How can you plead guilty and walk out and you don't even have to produce your child? Or produce your child, point blank period. You have to produce the full child, you know, and not like Adam Montgomery that did it with a tote bag, you know, like I don't know why he kept her like that. I felt like he was keeping her just in case, you know, CPS came. She's right here. She's fine. Like, what is wrong with people? I'll never understand. Good girl, Mia. Everyone said good girl, Mia. You can't really see it, but she has a little bow tie on her back. There, you can see it a little bit. She has a little bow. She loves that bow. Okay, Elizabeth, yeah. Thank you. I've never heard of Duchess Discussion before. I love them when people wear mods in other channels. Because Wiss is a mod too, another channel. But I love it. I think it's really cool. I think it's really, really cool. Never really. I was once, but that was forced on me, kind of. That was like, here you go. You're a mod, huh? What? What'd you say I was? She was 12. Yes, true crime and other stuff. Thank you, Otto. I need to get some new ones now. These glasses are like a year old, and now they're saying my vision changed again. I don't like that. So last night I showed you a picture of a little boy. I'm gonna see if I can find the exact picture. And this little boy melted my heart. Like when I saw this picture of this little boy, I was like, who is this cutie? Cutie, cutie, cutie. This is Elijah Vu, 3 years old. Man, so sad, these kids. 3 years old. He's missing from Wisconsin, Two Rivers. Man, it's sad. He was last seen by his caregiver. Let me go ahead and put up his missing persons flyer, because that are Amber Alert flyer, because that will help us all get a little bit more familiar with him. But I mean, adorable, adorable. Like I told you guys last night, the one with him in the car seat looks like Vincent when Vincent was a kid. When I saw pictures of Vincent, except for Vincent had darker hair and thicker hair. He had a bunch of hair. Kid had a little bowl cut, but how adorable. Elijah Vu, age 3, was reportedly last seen at 8 a.m. on February 20th, 2024 at a residence in the 3900 block of Mishicot Road in Two Rivers, Wisconsin. He was reported missing around 11 a.m. I don't know why 3 hours later, but Elijah is 3 foot tall, 45 pounds, with sandy blonde hair and brown eyes. Now, do you guys think 45 pounds for this little boy is a lot? Do you think that's big? I feel like he's smaller than that. But you guys would know more than me because you guys are moms. And I know you can tell by a kid, like, looking at him. You're like, that's how much he weighs. He's in this size. But to me, he looks a little smaller. He looks like a little thing, like 25 to 35 pounds. Maybe he's heavier than that. I don't know how heavy the kids are, but I just want to make sure we're getting the right information out. 45 pounds? Does he look like he would weigh that much? Maybe I could lift more than I thought, because I could lift him, no problem. With sandy blonde hair and brown eyes. He was last seen in gray sweatpants, long sleeve shirt with red and green dinosaur slip-on shoes. He may be carrying a red and white plaid blanket. Now, when I read that last night and it says he may be, you will know if he's carrying his favorite blankie with him. You're not going to have it in the house, you would think. Or maybe they're just going to say maybe he's having it in case the person that took him maybe has it. That's what I thought, Ashley. I thought he looked a little small. Yeah, 45 pounds seems like a lot. My puppy's 35 pounds. I know. I'm like, huh? Because I'm like, this little boy looks small to me. He just looks like a little thing. He's just the cutest thing. Like, cutest little boy. And then there's some newer news that came out with this too. And this was today. So I got some stuff from his aunt too. And then I'm on the Find Elijah Facebook discussion group too. So from what I'm hearing, his mother didn't have custody because I'm hearing that she might be incarcerated. Now, don't mark my words on that because there's different articles saying different things. But that's why I figured we would kind of learn the case together, both of us. But if anybody does have any information on little Elijah Vu, Two Rivers Police Department is the police department to call. And it's 1-844-267-6648. Sorry about that. It's 1-844-267-6648. And they do have an Amber Alert out on him. And they were, They were giving us that they were telling us like how, what goes into getting an Amber Alert issued. And I thought you had to be like in a vehicle, like, you know, with the license plate, and they had like license plate number, and that's how they knew. But I guess if they just have like a good description, and if the child is in danger, they can set out an Amber Alert. He looks so little and so cute. I know, Voodoo. Are both parents in jail? I think just mom's little socks. So I'm wondering the same thing as well. Because his aunt came forward. Now, I'm not sure if this is the aunt on, okay, this would be the aunt on his dad's side, I'm assuming, unless he has his mama's last name, which that's a big possibility as well, you know. Are both parents? Okay, thank you, preschool granny, or nanny, whichever. I thought it was just mom. Okay. Oh, Ladybug. It's sad that that's like, you know, part of some kids' life. You know, they are accustomed to it. It's very sad. And then look at this sweet little picture. That little boy doesn't pay no end of 45 pounds. He is the cutest little thing. I hope they find him okay. I really do. And his aunt's name's Linda. And it says, thank you everyone for your support. I am the aunt of Elijah Vu. My family and I have been very devastated and worried since Tuesday, 2/2024, when we heard the news about baby Elijah missing. We have been in contact with the police and detective since Tuesday. I have seen her on an interview too. Because it is still an ongoing active investigation, they have not released any information to us yet. We are getting desperate for answers, and we are asking the public to please continue to help share any and all of Elijah's posts on social media with friends and family. Continue to help search and find our baby so we can bring our baby back home. If anyone has any information, please come forth with any information you may have that can help the investigation. My family and I are very grateful for the amount of love and support from the amazing and wonderful volunteers and locals of Two Rivers, along with the outstanding Two Rivers Police and the fire search and rescue teams that have worked effortlessly to help find our baby boy. We cannot thank them enough. Your love and compassion is beyond words we cannot express. We hope that someone out there knows where our baby is and can help us find him and bring him home. And I hope that too. I really hope that. And though, so I guess that they're, I guess Elijah does have a sister. Let's see. I was just kind of going to go through here and see if there was anything that looked like it would stick out. And then I think I have some more stuff on here too. Why does that look like this is like Quentin's, this is like Quentin Simon's thing. Like somebody, I'm about to look that up. WISN. Because people are probably putting out, you know, like wrong, you know how like things are. I don't know. Maybe they're not. What is this? Amber Alert, landfill search. Maybe they're not. Shit. Okay. So they are. Oh my gosh. This looks, because this looks like Quentin. The little boy even reminds me of him, doesn't he? Like, let me put this picture back up because I don't know what it is. It's this picture here, I think. And you, if you guys know this, if you know the picture, you'll know. But this one reminds me of the picture with Quentin Simon in the orange shirt. And he's holding, I think he's wearing blue shorts and he's holding like his blankie or something. Him holding this little gift reminds me of, I don't know, just reminds me of them. So then now seeing, you know, something like that on Facebook, I thought that was like, I mean, when you see this, this is like giving me Quentin Simon vibes. And if you guys didn't follow that case, that was crazy. They're searching a landfill, I guess. Yeah. So let me see here. It says Amber Alert landfill search. And this was 1 hour ago. Man, I don't like this. Now I know that they did find a little shoe by the trash, and they were in the apartment complex where he lives, where his mom lives and stuff, or his, where he's living. I'm sorry. And they were going through the trash there. He's in Wisconsin, Two Rivers. I keep wanting to call it somewhere else, but I don't know where I'm wanting to call it. But yeah, let's see what this says.
Hours since authorities issued an Amber Alert for Elijah.
Let's see, how many hours?
It's now been 50 hours since 50. Authorities issued an Amber Alert for Elijah Vu. News Chopper 12 flew over Calumet County today as the FBI and police combed through a landfill in Hilbert.
That's nearly 40 miles west of Two Rivers, where police say Elijah was last seen. That's where 12 News' Kendall Keys is live tonight. Kendall, authorities have two people in custody.
Elijah's mother and another man who lives in this apartment building where investigators have been searching and collecting evidence. Right now, both are in custody. I'm told both are held on child neglect charges.
Man, I don't like that look.
The search for missing 3-year-old Elijah Vu crossed county lines Thursday. News Chopper 12 capturing exclusive video of FBI agents in hazmat suits searching a
That looks identical. I mean, I know that landfills probably all look the same, and you put little guys in white outfits and they all look the same, but the blue tint, I mean, all of it. I don't like
landfill
that.
Landfill in Calumet County. Heavy machinery working near a blue tent. The FBI telling 12 News they're assisting Two Rivers police in their investigation of the missing boy, but would not say what, if anything, they found.
Chief, do you have a suspect right now? And where are the mother and father?
He's like, we're not answering any.
Sorry, we're not going to take any questions at this time.
Let me tell you a little about that guy. You know how we had Sheriff Loins, with us with all, you know, Audrey's case. We've been dealing with Sheriff Loins, amazing officer, amazing sheriff, amazing. You know, he had bronchitis for a couple of days, so we had to let someone else take the reins. But, you know, when he did, when he talked, people listened, he gave us a lot of information, like all the information he could. They squeezed that lemon to every last drip drop. This dude, 4 minutes he was up there during the doing a press conference. I've never seen such a short press conference about a missing child in my life. And there was absolutely no questions that were allowed to be asked. Now, I don't know how I feel about him. If he finds that little boy and brings him home, we'll talk. But he was not very good with the people today.
We
just like no questions.
The search follows a news conference Wednesday night with Two Rivers Police, where investigators refused to take questions and revealed very little about the investigation. 12 News nothing. Learning police arrested Elijah's mother, Katrina Bauer, and another man early Wednesday morning. They're currently being held on child neglect charges.
Nobody. So then this is going to be from the dad's side. So yeah, like I said, I thought.
Nobody's confirming anything at this point. So we're just kind of like lingering around and hopefully we can get some answer from anybody at this point.
Oh my gosh.
Heartbroken relatives are desperate to know more about Elijah's disappearance.
Our heart is still so heavy about it. And we really just want him found and safe and back home.
Tuesday night, 12 News was there when investigators collected a small slip-on shoe with dinosaurs on it outside this Two Rivers apartment building. Investigators also going through the building's dumpster. Online court records showing the man under arrest lives in the building.
Kendall, you've been in Two Rivers every day since police issued the Amber Alert on Tuesday. You've noticed a change in search efforts today.
Kristen, Tuesday and Wednesday, we could see community members and police actively searching. Today, it's much quieter. There's just one police car that's sitting at this apartment building, and we've seen no organized searches.
Ooh. No organized searches. That means they're looking. They're looking somewhere else for him. Now, I will say during Quentin Simon's case, I'll never forget this. And I told you guys I would never forget this. During Quentin Simon's case, for 30 days, they stayed out in that landfill, and it was hot. It was nasty out there. They stayed out there. They sifted through 1.2 million pounds of trash before they found Quentin, or Simon Quentin, before they found him. Or I always get them names mixed up. Sorry, I mixed up again. But so 1.2 million pounds. Can you imagine what you would smell like when you come home from work? And then you would wake up smelling that, and then you go to bed smelling that. So the investigators can't get away from it. They can't get away from the actual crime itself because they're literally smelling it every night, you know, when they come home. So it's not like they can, like, you know, take themselves away from it if they could. If they were able to do that, but they can't. It was so hot. And it was like October, but it was not like that down there. It was like burning up down there. Rhonda, thank you. 9:30 a.m. tomorrow. Thank you. She better be in there in all of her glory. I mean, where's my post-it notes? It was a miracle that they found him. I don't know how they found him. But I remember it was when I read that in an article, I was like, what? I couldn't believe it. I know, Tina. You guys saw me just reading the Twitter post today. X post, whatever you want to call that place. I'm just going to start calling it. I don't even know. We'll think of a different name so that they can't change it anymore. But yeah, awesome rescuers. Wow, that little boy's adorable. Okay, let's see what else we've got. Okay, we got this. This came out at 7:20. So they're checking the landfill. I mean, that's not a good sign. They did say like they found a little blue shoe by the trash and stuff. So I'm hoping it wasn't his shoe. That's what I was hoping for. Let me see here. There was another page right here. So this is the Twin Rivers. So this today was, it was four minutes and 50 seconds. And
is everybody good?
It wasn't worth the 4 minutes and 50 seconds that I spent listening to it because they gave you no information at all. I don't even know if they said his mom was in custody or anything. Like, I don't even know if they said that. They were literally like, we'd like to thank, you know, all the people that they thank. And then, okay, we'll give you another update when we feel like it. And then that was it. But if they, you know, if they had a suspect or they had somebody, I think the mom is probably suspect, but the mom and the stepfather or the boyfriend or whatever. But I still feel like they could give out a little more information. Now I wanted to see I think this is the first time it was up. I wanted to go down to like, this was the first time that they put it up right here was 2 days ago. He was last seen wearing gray pants, long black or long sleeve, dark shirt, and red and green dinosaur shoes. And then there was another press release 2 days ago. Okay. And this is what we kind of read yesterday. The incident was reported to the Manitowoc County Joint Dispatch Center on 2/20/24 at 10:59 a.m. The caller identified as the child caretaker stated that Elijah was last seen at approximately 8 a.m. Now, that's too much time. That's 3 hours that you could not find the child that you were caring for. And he's a three-year-old. That's 3 hours. What were you doing? Were you looking for him like Leilani said she was too? Man. After receiving the call, officers responded to gather information and assist in searching within our original Facebook post and media release. We informed the public that Elijah described as having Hmong and white ethnicity with dark blonde hair and brown eyes. Hold on a second. What is this? What is... This isn't even like a thing. Is it? Oh, I guess it is. I'm like, I've never heard of this. Hmong Min language. I guess it's a language. I'm probably saying it wrong, but it's a ethnicity and it says it's an ethnic group of people who live in China and Southeast Asia. I've never heard, but I knew that he was Asian, Trisha. As soon as I saw him last night, because they were saying that he was a white boy. That's how they like worded it, and I was like, I was like, those little boys. That little boy has some cute Asian eyes. He's Asian American boy, because my boyfriend's Asian American, and the eyes, I don't know, they have very similar eyes. They have the slight, little bit of a slant, and it's the cutest ever. Yeah, maybe the baby had a driver's license. Maybe Elijah's like, okay, McDonald's breakfast is closing soon. Got to get there. I just don't understand people, how they... What else do you say? What else do you say after that? Like, I haven't seen him. Well, where was he? Well, I don't know. He was here. Now he's not. Like, how does that conversation go after 3 hours? You know what I mean? Like, after receiving the call, officers responded to gather information and assist in searching. Oh, wait. I already read that part. He was last seen wearing the gray pants, the dinosaur shoes, the long sleeve dark shirt. He is possibly carrying the red and white plaid blanket. Additional information received that Elijah is approximately 3 feet in height and has a birthmark on his left knee. Local, state, and federal resources were requested to assist with the search. These resources included, but are not limited to, canine and drone units. Additionally, information was sent out to all media, Facebook, a child is missing, and a Wisconsin Amber Alert has been issued. The Two Rivers Police Department is asking all residents to search any outbuildings, vehicles, or any other concealed areas that they may have on their property in an attempt to locate Elijah. Additionally, if residents have surveillance cameras or Ring doorbell, they are asking the public to please check them for images of Elijah. The Two Rivers Police Department has received requests from several individuals to use personal drones and personal canines to assist in searching. At this point, please refrain from the use of drones as it may interfere with law enforcement canine and drone searches. Maybe Vincent's home. Hold on 1 second. Well, actually, let me see my phone. Okay, yeah. Hold on 1 second. I'm going to shut the door. Okay, sorry about that. I was trying to mute it through the dog paws again, because I had sets of two dogs that time. But yeah, it's just asking anyone with information, call that tip line number, the 4-4-6. I'm sorry. I keep saying the six before the two. Dyslexic. Okay, let's start over again. 1-844-267-6648. Or utilize the P3 app for anonymous tips. Don't know what that is, but I'm sure you guys do. Now, I wanted to read this one up here before we, before I tell you about another update. I got an update in the Charlotte Cena case too. So we're just going to talk about all the kids real quick. We're going to get them all out. Getting them all out. We cover a lot of kids. So this was from tonight. And I think that people were, you know, they needed a little more information. So they came out with this. This is going to give us more information than what they gave us in the press conference today. We understand that there are a lot of emotions involving the ongoing search for Elijah. Elijah has not been located and is still missing. We are working closely with state federal agencies, and we are only releasing information that we are able to without jeopardizing this ongoing and multifaceted investigation. Some might be frustrated. However, everything we do is well thought out and planned in a combined effort with our main priority in locating Elijah. Okay. Okay, Sheriff, I'll take what I said back. The press briefing was to give facts and dispel rumors, as well as to let you know that factual information will only come from the Two Rivers Police Department. TRPD will continue to update the community with any facts and information that are able to be shared. If Elijah is located, we will share that information. Immediately after receiving the 911 call and based upon the circumstances, officers began searching for Elijah while we contacted the Wisconsin Department of Criminal Investigations, the FBI, a child is missing, National Center for Missing and Exploited Children. We requested a missing and endangered alert, an Amber alert, a Ring neighborhood alert, used local emergency alerts, contacted all municipal and county agencies for assistance, sent out Facebook requests for public assistance, brought in drones from Manitowoc Police Department and Manitowoc Sheriff's Office, canines from Manitowoc Police, Manitowoc Sheriff Office, and Sheriff Office, an air search from Wisconsin Army National Guard, as well as boats and UTVs from Two Rivers Fire Department and Manitowoc County Sheriff's Office. Now, see, that's all we needed in the press conference today, sir. So you could have said that. We're exploring all possibilities to locate Elijah. We are into our third day of searches for Elijah, and any assistance from the public will aid in our efforts. There are some things you can do to assist even outside the Two Rivers. Check everywhere a small child could hide, climb, or fall. Check your own property for any items that don't belong to you, which could include anything from Elijah, the red, white, black plaid blanket, or dinosaur printed shoes. Check your surveillance systems from February 12th through February 20th. We usually look back several days from the report to ensure that we are thorough, but not that far back. Look for anyone matching Elijah's description in your surveillance footage. You can also search public land for the aforementioned items or anything you feel relevant to this investigation. Please do not touch anything you find, but instead contact the tip line or Two Rivers Police Dispatch. You may have seen officers searching areas such as local rivers and landfills, and that is correct. We will leave no stone unturned. You will continue to see similar large-scale searches as we receive tips and continue our search for Elijah. For those of you who have shared information, thank you. As we learn more information, we will recontact you for continued assistance. We have had a very large police presence in our community from local, state, and federal authorities. We have no indication that any other children or individuals in the community are in danger. Authorities are working around the clock, following up on any tips and information that would lead us to find Elijah. We have some of the best resources in the country that have descended on our community to help locate Elijah. Jesse Vang and Katrina Barr have been arrested on allegation of child neglect. Both Vang and Bayer will have bail hearings at 12:45 p.m. on Friday, February 23rd at the Manitowoc County Courthouse. Well, I guess we'll just make a whole day of it. We will have some of the best resources in the country that have descended on our community. Due to victims' rights, we cannot release any further information on these charges. Okay. We will continue to update on the search for Elijah as we are able to do so. Factual and up-to-the-date information will only come from Two Rivers Police Department and TitaniumBuilt's YouTube page via media release, our Facebook page, or press conferences. Thank you to everyone who has assisted in the search for Elijah and continues to search for Elijah as that remains our top priority. Okay. I will make sure that I keep up with this. And I'm gonna be looking. The boyfriends, let me see. Jesse Vang. Like that. I highlighted it for you. What? Really, Susan Mann? I'll have to look him up. Jesse Vang. It definitely sounds like an Asian last name. I wonder if he's... Oh, my lordy. We got a picture. He looks scary. He looks scary as hell, y'all. Like, man. I'm going to show y'all what he looks like. To me, he looks scary. Oh, I was about to save it, but I mean, I could save that too. But look at these two. They look like winners to me. Now, what does this tattoo say? 9? Is it 920? Yeah, I don't like this. I don't like this at all. Yeah, I don't like it. I don't like the neck tap. Maybe it's the neck tap. Don't get neck taps, guys. They will never look good. They'll never be good. They will never age well. A neck tap will never age well. Believe you me. I got like 5. I had to get them removed. Just kidding. And that'd be funny, though, if I was like, yeah. Like, see? I mean, the ones that go like this, he's representing the numbers. It looks like a gang to me. But I'll double check. I'm gonna ask Vincent about this. Maybe he'll know. Maybe he'll know something I don't know. Cause like this dude looks like a gang affiliate person. And maybe he can even educate me on the ethnicity too. Cause I've never heard of that before. Oh man. Okay. Yeah, I definitely will, Susan. I definitely will. Because we're not done with this case at all. We're just doing a little dipping our toes in, I guess you could say. Now, Charlotte Cena, our girl Charlotte. We don't get cases very often where the person that's kidnapped, if it's a child especially, comes back to us alive. And in this time she did. We were on the lookout for this little girl for how long? Let me get a picture of her up here. Okay, I've got too many tabs open. I don't even know where you went, Charlotte. There's a picture of him. I don't want to look at him. Okay, they're not. Okay, we want to see a picture of Charlotte. They're just showing him on this. In this news. So I'm going to get a picture of her up so everyone can remember. Just in case anybody forgot what she looked like. This was Miss Charlotte. She was staying in the campground with her aunt, with her family. And she was riding her bicycle with a friend of the family or a family member, I believe at the time. She wants to take one more lap around by herself, like a big girl does, without anyone with her. And she never came back. She literally had never done this before and never came back. So for 50 hours, we were counting them down. You know, the first 48, they say. We hit like 50 hours. And we got off the live. And it was like 20 minutes after we got off the live. They were like, everyone's like, you guys were all like, they found her. I'm like, what? They did what? I couldn't believe it. So she was with Craig Ross Jr. And he's been in court since then. He was trying to get out of it, but looks like he's not going to try to do that anymore. An upstate New York creep admitted Wednesday that he, you know, the M word, a 9-year-old girl after plucking her from a Saratoga County campground last year. And now he faces 47 years behind bars. Now, the good thing about this is she will not have to testify. She will not have to get on that stand. So if there is one part, if there's that little voice in his head, you know, is saying, don't do this to this little girl. He listened. I'm surprised he has that voice in his head, but he listened. But he pled guilty to charges of kidnapping and predatory sexual assault of a child in the horrific case that saw the young girl snatched while riding her bike at the Moru Lake State Park on September 30th, setting off a massive manhunt for the missing girl. Remember, he wrote the ransom note, and that's what it was. He left his fingerprint on the ransom note because he put the ransom note in her family's mailbox. Not very smart. With the guilty plea today of Craig and Ross Jr., the victim and their family were able to hear the defendant admit his guilt to those heinous and despicable acts. I bet that was nice for them. His admission of guilt ends the question of who was responsible for the kidnapping that rallied our entire community together to assist in locating her. Remember that face? He will serve decades in prison before any parole consideration is available to him. Ross was nabbed after driving the child home in the middle of the night several days after taking her to leave a ransom note in the mailbox. A Milton resident, who asked for $50,000 for the girl's return, was spotted leaving the note by a state trooper who was keeping an eye on the house at the time. Cops ran the fingerprinting on the note, which matched Ross from a 1999 drunk driving arrest in Saratoga Springs. Bet you he never wishes he went out to the bar that night. There was a ransom note, and there was instrumental in leading us directly to the suspect. His fingerprint was already in the database. The girl was found inside the cupboard in the bedroom of Ross's camper, which is about 13 miles from her home. And I even said this the other night on our live. I said, before they found Audrii, I said, maybe he put her in a camper somewhere. And she can get water and she can get like food, but she can't get out. And then we find out, like, and I said, like Charlotte Cena. I said, but now we find out he really was living in a camper. The dude was in a camper. Oh, did I show you this one with Charlotte? And then here's the camper they found her in. Here. They're just everywhere. 420 is the Lisa. Oh man, I think you missed it last night, Ashley. You did. You weren't here last night, were you? Because Nancy Grace. I really need to get that on a shirt. Nancy Grace said, "Marijuana is the gateway drug." I'm like, oh my lordy, they haven't said that since I was in school, like since DARE was a thing, you know. Oh no, it's okay. Oh, Audra's blunt force trauma to her head. I'm wondering if he hit her with something or if he slammed her to the ground. I don't know, but oh, it does say 420. Oh my Lord, have mercy. I'm gonna give Vincent one of those. What's up with this guy's eyebrows though? It's like he's missing them, but they're there. It's like the shadow's there, but the eyebrow's not. I'm just like over here making fun of him. I'm poking fun. I'm allowed. I want to know where this baby is. Who that baby is so cute and seems so sweet. And I'm sorry, but these two do not look sweet. They don't look sweet to me. They don't. You're rubbing me the wrong way, guy. Let me make sure I don't take that name down because I want to know his name. Yeah, him. Yeah. Okay, there we go. But I think that's all I have for you guys tonight. And of course, you know, if we hear anything about these cases, of course, we're going to come back on and do them. Tomorrow, I'll be on to do Madalena Kojikari's case. I need to figure out like where it's going to be streaming from, like what this local station will be there. But it might be this one here. Yep. K or WBTV. I'll just do here. There it is. Okay, so now it's up on my Twitter, so we'll know. Wow. I guess I just saw this. Shaq gave away some shoes to this kid. It's a teen boy, and he wears a size 23. Shoe size 23 already. And so Shaq heard and guess donated him some shoes. That's so cute. Look at this guy. He's like so, he's smiling so hardcore. Like the things you can do to make someone smile, you know? It's very easy to make someone smile. Really. Opening the door for somebody. If you live, or if you live in Ohio like us, like I do, you hold the door open. If you see someone getting out of their vehicle all the way in the end of the parking lot and you're at the door, you wait. You wait the 20 minutes that it takes them to get out of the car, put their purse on their arm, shuts the door, locks it. You'll see me. I'll be that person holding the door open for the exceptionally long amount of time, you know. That's me. So thanks, Rhonda, for subscribing. Thank you. So yeah. That's just what I do. That's what we do in Ohio anyway. Maybe he colored his eyebrows on. Voodoo, I'm gonna ask Vincent because Vincent's got some thick eyebrows like that. But his are there. That guy's isn't even there. They're gone. They're like, did he shave them down? 420. Who the oh my God? It you gotta be a real special kind of stupid, really. To go to the tattoo shop and say, I want to put 420 on my neck. Like, what? Charlotte is. Charlotte's alive. Yeah, she's alive. Let me read the chat there a little bit. Oh, there's so many. I know. There really is. Yes, here in Ohio, we wait. We do, Rhonda. We wait. We wait and we wait and we wait a little longer. I always feel bad being that person, you know, that shuts the door on somebody. But people do that to me all the time. I'm just like, fine then. I know, I love Shaq too. No, he paid two cigs and a honey bun to the Ray Charles of the cell block for that tattoo. He really did. He really did. Man. Well, I don't know what it is about this guy, but he's rubbing me wrong. And this girl, she's rubbing me wrong. It looks like she needs someone to put helium in her head. I'm going hard tonight, guys. I'm going hard on making fun of people. I don't usually make fun of them until I know that they're guilty, but I'm sorry. Where's the child? You don't need Nate Eaton when you got me. Produce the children. I could do that. I could be that person. Okay, that's nothing with us. Okay, but I'm going to keep all these names written down, don't you worry. And if anything new comes out with any of these cases, I'll bring it up as soon as I can. But I will be back on to do a morning live for Madalena Kojikari because I want let her say she's guilty and walk out of there. If that is the case, then we're going to have to do a little fundraiser tomorrow. And I'm going to need roughly however much it takes to get me from point A to point B. From here to North Carolina. Just kidding. Because I really would be wanting to, I'd be like, Vincent, get in the car. Yes, the camper. Yeah. You never let me out of your sight. Mm-mm. I wouldn't let kids out of my sight nowadays. I mean, maybe that's why the good Lord hasn't blessed me yet. Cause they're like, you need to calm down first. Cause I would be a helicopter parent, but there's nothing wrong with that. Just making sure you're doing okay. Just making sure. But thank you guys for being here tonight. I really appreciate it so much. Don't forget to hit the like button and subscribe to the channel. All the fun things that we tell you to do, ask you to do. We do go over a lot of the cases that are out there on this channel. We're covering all of them. I feel like we're covering all of them. So if you're not subscribed to the channel yet, make sure you do. So that way you can come in and hang out, chat with us. But thank you guys for being here. And I will see you guys all tomorrow. Bye, guys.